जय गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीरवन चारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरिनाम संकीर्तन यज्ञ की ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय Reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, chapter 5, text number 14. Tato anyatha kinchan yadvikshat prithak drishas tat krita rupa naam bhihi न कर्हि चित् क्वापि न दुस्थिता मतिर् लभेत वाताहत नौर इवास्पदम् ततो अन्यथा किंचन यद्विक्षतः पृथक् दृशस्तत्कृतरूपनामभिः न कर्हि चित् क्वापि च दुःस्थिता मतिः लभेत वाताहत नौर इवास्पदम् ततो अन्यथा किंचन यद्विक्षतः पृथक् दृशस्तत्कृतरूपनामभिः न कर्हि चित् क्वापि च दुःस्थिता मतिः लभेत वाताहत नौर इवास्पदम् word to word translations tatah from that anyatha apart kinchan something yat whatsoever vivakshatah desiring to describe prithak separately drishah vision tatkrita reactionary to that रूप फॉर्म नाम भी बाय नेम्स न कर्चित नेवर क्वापि एनी च एंड दुस्थिता मति ऑसिलेटिंग माइंड लभेत गेन्स वात आहत ट्रबल्ड बाय द विंड नौह बोट इव लाइक आस्पदम प्लेस ट्रांसलेशन एंड परपोर्ट बाय हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस एसी भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी प्रभुपाद ट्रांसलेशन वॉट एवर यू डिजायर टू डिस्क्राइब दैट इज सेपरेट इन विजन फ्रॉम द लॉर्ड सिंपली रिएक्ट्स विद डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स नेम्स एंड रिजल्ट्स टू एजिटेट द माइंड एज द विंड एजिटेट्स अ बोट which has no resting place. It's a long purport. Sri Vyasadeva is the editor of all descriptions of the Vedic literatures, and thus he has described transcendental realization in different ways, namely by fruitive activities, speculative knowledge, mystic power, and devotional service. Besides that, in his various Puranas, he has recommended the worship of so many demigods in different forms and names. The result is that the people in general are puzzled how to fix their minds in the service of the Lord. They are always disturbed about finding the real path of self-realization. Srila Narad Dev is stressing this particular defect in the Vedic literatures compiled by Vyasadeva. And thus, he is trying to emphasize describing everything in relation with the Supreme Lord and no one else. In fact, there is nothing existent except the Lord. The Lord is manifested in different expansions. He is the root of the complete tree. He is the stomach of the complete body. Pouring water on the root is the right process to water the tree, as much as feeding the stomach supplies energy to all parts of the body. Therefore, Srila Vyasadeva should not have compiled any Puranas other than the Bhagavata Purana, because a slight deviation from that may create havoc for self-realization. If a slight deviation can create such havoc, then what to speak of deliberate expansion of the ideas separate from the absolute truth, personality of Godhead. The most defective part of worshipping the demigods is that it creates a definite conception of pantheism, ending disastrously in many religious sects, detrimental to the progress of principles of Bhagavatam, which alone can give the accurate direction for self-realization in eternal relation with the Supreme Personality of Godhead by devotional service in transcendental love. The example of the boat disturbed by the whirling wind is suitable in this respect. The diverted mind of the pantheist can never reach the perfection of self-realization due to the disturbed condition of selection of the object.
Om Ajnanatimirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakanvitamscha हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधो दीनबंधो जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत श्री राधा कांत नमस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी श्री राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा Welcome to today morning Srimad Bhagavatam class. Again, somebody else was supposed to be speaking, so I just filled in the place. This verse mentions about how this full set of verses is basically Narad Muni is stressing the super excellence of pure devotional service. It's condemning any other things which Srila Vyasadeva has written. In fact, I was searching the internet about the various lectures available on this verse, and it was really not available actually. Prabhupada gave a lecture on this verse in 18 July 1969 in New Vrindavan. That was about 10 lines, and then he continued on to the next verse. So, but Srila Prabhupada basically mentioned that as a conversation, if Vyasadeva can ask Narad Muni that I have written so many literatures, even Mahabharata I have written, which has Bhagavad Gita, and Bhagavad Gita as spoken by Sri Krishna. So, I have spoken about Sri Krishna. But then Naradji, as a conversation, Prabhupada is explaining, he's saying that although you have written Bhagavad Gita, you have put it in a scene. Krishna is put as a sideline, as a sidelight. He uses the three words that Krishna is a sidelight, he's sidelined, and he's just a scene in Mahabharata. Just one part. You need to describe directly the pastimes of Lord Sri Krishna straight away. Not even because, as in the purport Prabhupada is writing, people in general are very much confused about the path to self-realization. So he mentions one word, pantheism, which I was searching, and I found Chaitanya Charan Prabhu's few things. So we'll discuss a little bit about that, and then we'll discuss about how the mind is being disturbed by the various various topics which are presented in this material world. The example is given of a boat. So pantheism, the definition found is basically you see God in everything in this material world as a diffused entity, and as if there is no person. Personal conception to God is denied, and because of that it leaves lot of unanswered questions, whether he exists or where does everything come from. So that is about it. And then Chaitanya Charitamrita mentions it's not pantheism which is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita, but panentheism. So very difficult concept, but basically that when Krishna says that I am in everything and everything is in me, which means that although everything is coming from the energy of Krishna, but Krishna also exists otherwise. So one time I was distributing Back to Godhead magazines in the Kumbh Mela in Nasik Kumbh Mela and we were giving out Back to Godhead magazines about 5 rupees each, very cheap, and just Back to Godhead, no other books. So there were many devotees with us, and Kumbh Mela means it was packed. There was, Nasik is not such a big place, so there were huge crowds just coming in and going. And we were at the Kala Ram temple, there is a Lord Ram temple over there, and one devotee was carrying a pack of about 30-40 Back to God, thin Back to Godhead magazines, and he was distributing. So he felt the urge to go to the washroom, but nobody was around because people were just coming so much. I was far away, every other devotee was far away. So what he did was, he kept that stack of books under a tree and covered it with his saffron shawl, and then went away to relieve himself. By the time he comes back, there is half a kilometer line in front of that saffron cube, and somebody is breaking coconut, somebody is applying kumkum, and it's like, he comes and he tries to take it away, and people say, "No, no, humko hamara ye karne do. You go right now." Because people, they thought that there is this orange cube under a tree, and one person might have done something, and then there was a huge line, and then we had to explain to them that although this is worshipable, but this is ours. It's not to be. So in general, we see that people in general, everywhere, all around the world, not just India, they are kind of fruitive. They want something in return. Prabhupada explains, like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, na dhanam na janam na sundarim. I don't want anything of this material world. And then somebody may ask, okay, so you want liberation, right? He said, I don't even want liberation. Mama janmani janmanishware bhavatat bhaktir. That I want to life after life keep on serving you. We also see the common Ganesh ji's aarti which they sing, Jai Deva Jai Deva Jai Mangal Murti Darshan Matrena Kamana Purti. They are saying that just by seeing you, Darshan Matrena Kamana Purti, Mana Kamana. So you have, everyone has that desires. So I'm just trying to explain how these demigod worship is basically going towards fruitiveness. In fact, one time somebody asked Srila Prabhupada that, can I not do bhakti to Lord Shiva? You are doing bhakti to Krishna. So I can also have pure devotion to Lord Shiva. Then Prabhupada answered, yes, it's definitely possible. But in general, if somebody is going to a liquor bar, so it is understood that he is going to drink liquor, not milk. It is general thing. And we see so many demons all over the history, Hiranyaksha, Hiranyakashipu, Vrikasur. They all worship Lord Shiva, Brahma Ji, Ravana also worship Lord Shiva. Tulsidas Ji writes that the Lanka, which Ravana got by trying to put his heads in fire, was given to Vibhishan by when he just bowed down to Lord Ram. That's all. In fact, there is a common scene in movies where the hero comes to in front of the deity and says, "Khush to bahut hoge aaj tum, aaj mera ye whatever something that nuksan." So and then bells start ringing and lights and the deity starts moving and finally falls down and somebody in the hospital just opens the eyes. So that all shows that we are trying to force the deity, force God into by our moving the bells, and that we want that desire to get something is very strong. And another time we were distributing books in Vikramgarh, one of the villages near our GV. So we were, all this is long time back, but I just remembered the stories. So one person, he came, and in general in villages, people, when they see this color, they consider you as God only, almost like that. Whatever you are, any saintly appearing thing, appearing person. So we used to meet many people who used to treat us like that. So one time we were on a table with books. So a person came and shouted, "Dev Allah," and he pointed the hands to us and me also. So immediately I just looked away, and because that is detrimental to devotion. We are not Krishna. We are simple jiva. And then again he said, "Dev Allah." So it was a market. We used to put on market days, like it's a weekly market in villages. So everybody started looking at us. And then he said, "Dev Allah, agarbatti ghya." He was having that agarbatti. So he's using our dress as his business. So that is what people are generally doing. And they are, in general, never satisfied. What to speak of in religion, even in general in life. Like I remember when I used to do these deity backups many years back. So there are 7 backups in a day. So in every backup, a person can feel dissatisfied. These deity services, if you understand what I'm speaking about. So early morning, if somebody is going at 4:40 or 4:30 a.m., then he's feeling that, oh, morning program, I joined the temple for morning program and I'm missing the morning program. It's just so much service. Then if he's given, okay, next 7 a.m. backup, he feels Guru Puja, dancing with devotees, Kirtan. This is a Sankirtan movement. So I'm missing Guru Puja, I'm missing Bhagavatam, which is life and soul of devotion. Then somebody may say, okay, 10 o'clock backup. So somebody may feel that after Bhagavatam, many devotees are resting or they are doing some yoga or something after class. And I'm just here inside at 10 o'clock, I'm just washing the utensils that way. And then if there is a 12:30 backup, one feels His Holiness Radhanath Swami Maharaj is told to take prasad with devotees. And I am here inside washing the vessels. I am not able to take prasad with devotees. I am not hearing Srila Prabhupada Lilamrit. So they are again tense. Okay, somebody may say, no issue, you take 3 p.m. fruit cutting deity service. So then he can feel people are practicing music, mridangas, or they are reading shastras. They are developing their skills and I am here just inside the deity room cutting fruits. Somebody may feel, okay, take a 7 p.m. backup in the evening, which is one of the last second in the day. He says, evening time kirtans are there, Zoom meetings are there, programs are there. I'm just inside here doing various services. Somebody may say, okay, finally, at least take the last one, the 9 p.m. backup. If you are not happy with any of these, 9 p.m., it's so late at night. And then the body becomes so active and we cannot sleep till about 11:30 and then japa is gone and everything is finished. So to explain, the thing is that any condition person will never feel 100% fully satisfied or convinced that I am happy. So this is what is life, that sometime or the other, you will find some sand mixed somewhere. So Krishna says, this is avidhi purvakam, that one should feel satisfied. And the verse translation mentions that these things agitate the mind just as wind agitates the boat which does not have a shelter. Boat, if you have seen on a sea or anywhere, if it's not anchored, then it's really moving. I have personally tried sometime. I was trying to swim to that boat, and when you go close, it's going, it's really moving. So here the analogy of the mind is given. And any verses somebody remembers about boat in our scriptures, either Gita or Bhagavatam? Yeah, Nudeva Adhim. That is in Bhagavatam, and also Bhagavad Gita has one. Indriya Nam Hi Charatam Yan Mano Anuvidyate Tad Asya Haranti Pragyam Vayur Navam Ivambasi. As a strong wind sweeps away the boat. And Nudeham Adhyam. So basically this Bhagavatam verse explains that how human life is very rare, and human body is just like a boat, and Guru is the captain of the boat, and the scriptures are like favorable winds. Previously, as few days back, Akinchan Krishnaprabhu explained that the ships used to have sails and they used to fly by the wind. So I again remember one story. One time we were somewhere near Indore distributing books in companies. And what had happened was that our books were falling short. And it rarely happens. There were huge lines of people waiting to take our books in companies, even late at night. There is three shifts. Night shift around 2 a.m. We were distributing, and people were like so eager to take them. We were feeling, what's happening? These books were going like hotcakes. So then we had told our book department over here to send more books, more Bhagavad Gitas, more Bhagavatams. And what had happened was that the station people did not pay attention when the books came, and the train was bound for Delhi and the books went to Delhi. So then we came and asked the counter that where are our books. He said, where is your receipt? Because in general, the person who is sending the goods, he should have the receipt. And we didn't have the receipt because we never expected that our books will be going. So the book distribution department, what he had done was, the person, on one of the boxes, he had written SP Ki Jai out of about 15-20 boxes, and the receipt was in that. And the station person knew that these things happen many times. The people don't have the receipt, or it's some other person coming. So he instinctively knew, and he was not paying attention. He said, books, they are called carryover. Books carryover ho gaya. So they will be coming back. Yeah, so we requested him to at least phone. And so the books were coming. And then this time we were very careful that when the train comes, we will be there. So when the train came, our luggage compartment, the books which were in the luggage compartment, they came out of the platform. Means the train was so big that it came on the tracks. And we were so frantic that we should open it, and because we were not believing that this time also station persons will take care. So all of our book distribution devotees, they opened and went inside. But before that, there was some big official. He had just shifted his house. So his almirah cupboard was coming. So he said, aap log baju mein ho jao, pehle, first my thing has to come. So the train was supposed to stop for about just 6 to 7 minutes at that place. And our pulses were just, we were thinking how we will take out the boxes. So he very coolly, he had a servant, and the servant unloaded his almirah, and then we said, okay, Hare Krishna, jaiye abhi. And so we climbed, and then jisko bolte na vinash kale viprit buddhi, you don't realize, we started searching for that box SP Ki Jai. And it was full dark inside that compartment, and 15-20 boxes with all other luggage. So we started opening, we said, forget it, let's start opening each box, there will be a receipt inside. But we could not find it. Then it struck to someone, the train will be leaving, at least empty the boxes, the receipt will take care. So then, after that thought, we started throwing the boxes outside very fast, and by the time last box was thrown, the person came, locked, and the train went. The books were all over the tracks because some boxes had been opened. And then we searched, where is this box? SP ki jai. And then we finally found the receipt. But now what was there? That all these boxes were on tracks, and we were just 4 or 5 of us. We could not take the boxes alone. So we called one person with a thela. His thela was already in gone condition. He was a Muslim person. So then we loaded all the 15-17 boxes on his thela. This paper has a lot of weight. I think his thela never took that much weight. It was just going left and right. And there was this road is there. Basically, there is some type of a road sometimes which crosses all the tracks. And we were on another platform, we were not on the first platform. It was on fourth or fifth platform. So on the road we were going. Now you have to visualize a little bit. And I was carrying two boxes myself because it was open. It was not fitting on his thela. I was walking ahead, thela was behind me, and everyone was behind the thela. And there was a train here which had stopped, and he was going. I went ahead, and I just saw that there's another train coming behind it, from behind towards our direction. I crossed, and the train was few feet away. I was expecting that this thela wala, everything is gone now. Somehow I lost my voice also. I could not. I turned back, because I was shocked that I was just saved from that train. The train was coming from behind another train. So then I turned and said, and then the train passed. I was just waiting with the boxes, what is going to happen? So then when the train passed, I saw that old thelawala, he was in front. He had just stopped. And then nobody said anything. I also could not say, and they started walking. On the way, I said, "Aaj to tum upar jaane wala tha." He said, he was a Muslim person. He said, "Narayan ki kripa hai apun ke upar." I had no words. How he stopped, the inertia, it was impossible. So we see. How this human life is so rare, padam padam yata vipdam na tesham. So today's verse mentions, na karhichit kvapi cha dusthita matir. Dusthita matir is the oscillating mind. And there are two other words about mati, sumati and kumati. Sumati is sundara mati, kumati is kumargagami mati. The mind, oscillating mind, which takes us to the wrong path. It is said, mana eva manushya nam karanam bandha mokshayo bandhaya vishaya sango nirvishayi muktai nirvishaya mana. This is from Vishnu Purana. It is sometimes observed that sadhakas are on two boats. One is a bhakti. They have one foot on bhakti and another foot on sense gratification. It is like our mind is showing us the Maya fest with 100% immersive reality. So we have to cut it with the scissor, and we have to engage in Krishna fest and with more immersive reality. And that's why it is said in Bhagavad Gita, Tasmat Indriyanado, means in the very beginning, as soon as the contemplation begins. It is just like we have this video broadcasting. Sometimes we are showing Gaur Nitai deities, sometimes we are showing Gopalji deities. And there is a transition. It's called transition. It's called merge transition. When Gopalji changes into Gaur-Nitai, it's just merge transition. So normally a sadhaka kind of gets curious that what is this? Let me see what is entangling the non-devotees and what is Maya. He tries to play kabaddi with Maya. And then when the merge transition comes, and he doesn't even understand that he is into sense gratification. Or another example can be given, just like a magician. He's waving the handkerchief, gilly 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 gilly, phat, and then the pigeon comes. So you don't realize when I fell into sense gratification, that the thoughts are just coming. And so that's why Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, tasmatvam, in the very beginning, as soon as, don't let it get into meditation and let the mind go into contemplation. That's why it is said that once these type of thoughts come, one should try to get busy. And Krishna mentions in Bhagavad Gita, Daivi esha gunamai, mama maya durate. So, Durataya is for the living entity. And then in the Bhagavatam, there is a verse which comes when Srila Vyasadeva is meditating. And he says, Bhakti yogena manasi, samyak pranite amale. That the maya is mayam chatad apashrayam. Maya is in full control of Krishna. So, although maya may trouble the jiva, but bhakti attracts Sri Krishna. In Nectar of Devotion, one of the six symptoms of pure devotional service is Sri Krishna Karshini. So, if we take shelter of bhakti and the process of bhakti, then our boat has some anchor. That is the shelter. Normally, it is experienced that if there is Krishna in our life, then there is no maya. Krishna Suresam, maya hai andhakar. But if there is still darkness in the life of a sadhaka, that means he does not have a real sun. He may be having a sun which is painted on paper, something like the pictures, which means that is not the real sun. I'll explain what is real sun and what is this. So it is said that Goswami and Godas, the only difference is that Godas agrees to the demands of the mind, and Goswami, he does not agree. So that means that the thought comes to both. Yamunacharya, he says this, Yadavdi mamacheta Krishna padara vinde navanavarasa dhamni udyatam rantum asit. And then he mentions that tad avadhi bata nari sangame smarre mane. So that means the thoughts are there. And then he is saying, bhavati mukha vikara shustu. He is not spitting on the sense object. Many people feel he is spitting on the thought. So Goswami and Godas, that is the difference. And Guru, Sadhu and Shastra are like, they are like, if you have seen birds which are flying in the sky, each bird is flying on their own strength, with its own wings. It's not that one bird can fly on top of other, sitting on top of other. So similarly, they can inspire us. Guru can give us instructions, Shastra can give us messages. But ultimately, we have to take the choice. We have to learn, and we can get inspired from them. And basic difference between wish and vishaya is wish that kills this body, but vishaya kills many, many bodies, many lifetimes. Once we get into that cycle, that's why Srila Lochandas Thakur sings, vishaya chhadiya se rase majiya, mukhe bolo hari hari. So one has to leave the sense objects and and engage se rase majiya, engage in Krishna Katha. Srila Govindadas Kaviraj also sings, Vifale Sevinu Kripana Durjana Chapala Sukha Lava Lagiri. This, in Bhagavad Gita also, it is mentioned, Adyanta Vanta Konteya Chapala Sukha. It is, It is like it long periods of dissatisfaction and a short amount of happiness, whatever happiness you can call it. So it is not worth it, not worth the effort. And Sripad Shankaracharya also says, Angam galitam palitam mundam dashana vihina jatu tundam vriddho yati grahitva dandam tadapina munchati asha pindam. The person has become old. This verse was spoken by Sripad Shankaracharya one time when he was going through the streets of Varanasi. He was originally born in South India. And he was going in the streets of Varanasi and saw one old Brahmana who was reciting grammar, various grammar rules of Sanskrit. And then he composed these verses, many very, very interesting and knowledge-giving verses. So one of this is this, that you are old, dashana vihina jatu tundam, the teeth have all fallen. Vriddho yati grihitva dandam, you are holding a stick and still you have all these asha pindam. So it is said that in general, according to the Vedic civilization, as the age advances, one has to achieve spiritual and emotional maturity. It is not good if one just gets old and does not have spiritual realizations and emotional maturity. Because already old age troubles the body. There's a shloka which says, Vatadai Doshena, means where in Varaha Puran, Krishna is explaining that in old age you have all the problems related to Vat. And if the devotee cannot remember me due to all this, then Krishna mentions in this shloka that Aham Smarami, Nayami, he remembers the devotee and takes him back to Godhead. But then one has to strive to do his part. So right now here we are talking about what a devotee can do in doing his part. So it is said there is a public victory and there is a private victory. Public victory is basically our money, our control, our position. Basically all the six Shad Aishwaryas. Aishwarasya, Samagrasya, Viryasya, Yashasya, Shriya, Gyan, Vairagya. Anything which people can see, any skills, any controls, that gives us little happiness. In Gujarati, there's a saying, Koni upar gaur chotavine chakvanu, which means that you stick jaggery on your elbow and try to lick it. It's very difficult. So, public victory is like that. You get famous, people start following you, Likes, subscribe, share, and then, but you see that there is no personal life. Your devotion is, I should not use the word you again, is basically we and I myself. And private victory is nobody knows about it. What are spiritual realizations? But it is more satisfying. Usually it is seen that there are many things which give us shelter of Krishna, like our services, our relationship, our money, many things which give us shelter of Krishna. But many a times what happens is people start taking those shelters as substitute for Krishna himself. As if they are chanting or doing something, they are trying to think of services. So what happens? Krishna sometimes takes these shelters away from us. So that one feels helpless and directly takes shelter of Krishna. It may mean health, it may mean money. The shloka which comes in Srimad Bhagavatam, Brahmaji says, Tatte nukampa sushamikshamano, bhunjan evatmakritam atmakrit. So, even we see the case of Draupadi, when Draupadi in general was protected by her husbands. But when she saw that her husbands cannot protect her, then she raised her hands and directly took shelter of Krishna. So, Krishnaika Sharanam is one of the basic qualities of a devotee. Even in Damodar Leela, now I am talking about that real sun in our life, which I just mentioned some time back. Krishna Surya Sam Maya Hai Andhakar. So we see that one day when Yashoda Maya was churning butter, and then Krishna woke up, came and held the churning rod, that now you stop that service and pay directly attention to me. You don't keep doing that service. Pay direct attention to me. So that is what we should do while we are chanting. We should try to our best just chant and hear. Some example is like one day before marriage, one time a groom got a message from his to-be wife that hamari shaadi nahi ho sakti, kahin aur fix ho chuka hai. So he saw that message one day before and the marriage, and he immediately texted, hall book ho chuka hai, cards chhap chuke, sherwani bhi aa chuki hai, abhi kyun nahi ho sakti. So the bridegroom message, sorry, sent you by mistake. So that's what we are doing with Krishna. When we are chanting, we should be sending this message ki sorry ye shaadi nahi ho sakti, to our anarthas, to our all the thoughts which are coming. Instead we are sending these messages to Krishna, that and Krishna is saying ki subah ho gayi, uth gaye, mangal aarti ho gayi, vancha kalpataru vasya ho gaya, abhi kyun nahi. So we should be sending these messages to our thoughts, that shaadi kahin aur fix ho chuki. That means we should be with Krishna. So chanting has to be very internal thing, antarmukhi. Normally few times we see that as soon as chanting starts, person become very bahirmukhi, Hare Krishna, Hare, and it's like one has to do it for his internal purification more than anything else. One of the things I remember from again deity services, when we used to wash these copper cups and pots, so those pots, I don't know, many devotees get many realizations while washing those pots. I got this thought that if you want to shine it fast and shine it nicely, then you have to apply nice amount of pressure, lot of pressure, and it has to be a rough green colored scotch bright, then it starts shining. What will happen if we put a liquid soap on it and use us that sponge for shining it? I don't know how long it will take. So that is what our cleansing our heart is like. That we have to struggle, we have to do our part. It's troublesome, it takes lot of effort shining those copper pots. Morning backup, everything is there, almost all the pots, all the achman cups and everything. So that is how the process of chanting has to be. And I'll just end with a sweet shloka from Srila Rupa Goswami. If anybody has questions, we can take after that. Manasi jafani juste labdhopatosmi duste तिमिर गहन रूपे हंत संसार कूपे अजित निखिल रक्षाम हेतु मुद्धार दक्षाम उपनय मम हस्ते भक्ति रज्जुम नमस्ते. श्रील रूप गोस्वामी इज एक्सप्लेनिंग द पोजिशन ऑफ अ जीवा सोल विच हैज फॉलन इन दिस मटीरियल वर्ल्ड. ही इज एक्सप्लेनिंग दैट देर इज अ पर्सन हु हैज फॉलन इन द वेल, एंड this well is very dark and there is snake around, and he wants to come out. So he is requesting somebody who is on top to throw a rope. So who is that person? It is that jiva. Rupa Goswami is explaining that jiva has fallen in this dark world of this material world. Hanta samsara kupe, This is the well of birth and death, cycle of birth and death. And Manasi is a funny jushte. These snakes are the ulterior, selfish, material desires which are constantly biting us. So, I have fallen in this well. Hanta samsara kupe, hetu muddhara daksham, upanaya mama haste, bhakti rajyum namaste. So, he is requesting that Lord Krishna, you please throw the rope of bhakti in my life, little bit. And I promise that I will hold that rope tightly and you then pull me out. So, this is the super excellence of devotional service, in which two fingers, we try from our side to control the oscillating mind, and then Krishna also helps us. So, these are a few thoughts. Although I just, actually speaking frankly, I prepared for about 30 hours. Yesterday full day and something in the evening the day before. Just a compilation. I didn't collect anything new. Whatever was in my notes, I compiled it. Okay. Granthraj Srimad Bhagavatam ki, Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai.